Did you know that hearing is much more than just a mechanical feeling? Our brain perceives sounds as sensual sensations. And when it comes to senses, you know you can be fooled, right? Well, there are many audio illusions and phenomena that might drive you insane, but also, like, let's say, binaural beats, may help manage pain or promote creativity. In today's video, we will not try to ease your mind or make you feel less anxious. On the contrary, we will do our best to increase your cortisol levels with a small game.
Welcome everyone to Audiofool or Audiofool. The rules are pretty simple. I, the vicious office fellow, going to ask those two dum-dums some questions regarding sound perceptions and psychoacoustics. Whoever gets it right first pushes the button and a great sound appears, after which he or she will give the answer and is a step closer to win everything. In other words, one of them proves to be a knowledgeable audiophile and the other one proves to be a miserable audiophool. The rules are clear, we are all here, so let the game begin. Are you ready?
Yeah.
First question. Is a loudspeaker a transducer? Alex?
Yes, a loudspeaker is a transducer. It converts one type of energy into another.
Good answer! Point for Alex.
Yes.
Second question. What is the range of audible frequencies for a human ear?
I know.
Agnieszka?
Yes, it's from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Although, I know I read it, children can hear a bit higher and it's to more than 20 kHz. But they lose it with time. So, life.
Correct answer. Point for Agnieszka. Question 3. What is the difference between siren and a loudspeaker? Alex?
In sirens, the acoustical form of energy corresponds to the electrical one.
But that's... okay.
Wrong.
Agnieszka?
In sirens, the acoustical energy corresponds with the electrical one.
But that's... So, I guess you're both right? That's a tie. Question 4. What is voice coil? What does voice coil do? Agnieszka?
It's a component of a speaker. So basically it's an electromagnet and, in other words, it is a coil of wires wrapped around some magnetic metal, might be iron. So it carries the audio frequency currents corresponding to the sound waves.
Perfect. Point for Agnieszka. Question 5. What makes a great speaker? Alex?
It's a little bit personal question, but I believe it's accuracy. A great speaker does not color sound. When you are recording, for example, a roaring tiger or a crying baby, you want to reproduce the same sounds. So pure sound, a clean sound. A clean sound means that there are no additional frequencies and there are no digital noise, and it's exactly what we want.
Perfect! Point for Alex. We are now halfway through and you know what it means?
Yeah.
It's time for a comic relief!
Yay!
Knock knock! Alex!
Who's there?
Cow goes!
Cow goes who?
Cow goes moo! Question 6. What is a woofer? Agnieszka!
It's a low frequency speaker!
What is a tweeter? Agnieszka!
It's a high frequency speaker!
Good one! I'm sorry Alex, but 2 points for Agnieszka! Question 8. What does stereo mean? Alex?
It's a sound system with two separated channels.
Yes, and you get the point. Question 9. What an alarm signal should be? Both?
Audible.
Red?
But that's... okay, again, that's a tie. Okay. Question number 10. Papers out, please. And please, pay attention, because this is quite demanding, alright? Ready?
Yep.
Ready.
All the sounds according to decibels, from the lowest to the highest. A. Max earphone volume. B. Toilet flush. C. Balloon pop. D. Space. And E. Baby cry. 10 seconds. hurry up, hurry up. Oh, don't look. Thank you. And Alex, thank you. Let me check that. Oh, come on. You're both wrong. What? I told you to pay attention.
Okay, okay.
Okay, let's try something simple. Got it. What is louder? A black hole or space? Alex.
A black hole.
Space.
Yes.
A black hole? Really? And you measure the sound with a big telescope?
Whatever. What's the score? Can we have the score, please?
Yes. I counted the points and it seems not what you don't know that gets you in trouble. It's what you know for sure that that just ain't so. And this time, the true audiophile is Agnieszka! Congratulations! And here is your reward. Something to cover those precious ears of yours. And you, Alex, are the true audiophile. Thank you, everyone.
Have you ever heard a glacier melting or a bat echolocating? No? Well, how about a buzzer, a siren, or a regular speaker notifying you of serious hazards happening just around the corner? If your answers are still no negative, we can provide you with all of the above. Just enter tme.eu and enjoy it. Well, I mean buzzers, sirens, and speakers. For echolocating bats, visit Discovery Channel.